Potatoes are great. Who doesn't love potatoes? But what they do to blood sugar is an absolute crime. I call potatoes one of the big four starches, which are nightmares for diabetics. The big four include potatoes, pasta, bread, and rice. Now, nearly everybody knows that diabetics have no business eating sugar, sugary desserts, sugary drinks, and so forth. But many seem clueless that these big four starches, along with some other starchy foods, are equally deadly. Many diabetics faithfully abstain from pie and cake and ice cream and candy bars, but they think nothing of eating huge mounds of rice, or large chunks of bread, or generous portions of French fries, mashed potatoes, and baked potatoes. And then they wonder why they're having so much trouble keeping their blood sugar levels in line. Now, it's not that there are not other starchy foods which will do this for you, but at least for Americans, our four most popular and beloved starches are bread, pasta, potatoes, and rice. Just eliminate these foods from anybody's diet and they would be almost certain to lose weight and improve their A1C scores in a major way. I couldn't tell you how long it's been since I ate a baked potato like this. I'd guess it's been over 10 years. I gave up on potatoes a long time ago because I read that they convert their starches into sugars lightning fast once they enter your body. I didn't even bother to test them. Nearly everything I read about potatoes was bad news for diabetics, and I just decided to give up on them for a lifetime and began looking at other, kinder, gentler foods to take their place. High on my list of food substitutes for potatoes are salads, nuts, and avocados. But today, I'm going to break my potato fast and eat a full baked potato. Now, this particular potato came with a nutritional information label on the wrapping. The nutritional info said it possessed 26 grams of carbs with 2 grams of fiber. But truthfully, I think they're lying. The websites on the internet I've checked list a medium baked potato as having around 37 grams of carbs with 4 grams of fiber. A large baked potato will have nearly 70 grams, which is equal to about 2 candy bars. And the blazing speed at which this potato will convert to sugar enable it to be just about as problematic as a Snickers candy bar. One problem with produce is you can never get an exact carb measure. They're all slightly different in size and in their ripeness, which can also affect carbs and glycemic load. In any case, potatoes have a reputation for doing a real number on blood sugar. And so I'll try this one medium-sized baked potato and get back to you. Because of the speed of potatoes to break down into sugar, I'm going to test myself at 15 minutes, again at 30 minutes after I eat, and then at the 1 hour mark. I'll be back in a little over an hour to give you the results, but it'll only take you a second, and we'll see what this one potato has done to me. Well, excuse me while I smear some butter and put a little salt on this baby to make it a little bit more palatable. And truth is, I'm going to enjoy it. It's been a long time, and probably unless I do another experiment, it'll be a long time before I have another, if ever. When people are extremely good at what they do, we call them competent, capable, able, skilled, or maybe talented. After this blood sugar test, one thing I have to say is that potatoes are extremely competent, capable, able, skilled, and talented at raising blood sugar. I expected a blood sugar rise, and I definitely got one. I was so eager to see exactly what this potato was going to do to me, I ended up measuring my blood sugar every 15 minutes. And what I saw was dreadful. My pre-meal test showed my blood sugar at 101. 15 minutes after eating the baked potato, the inside, not the skin, my blood sugar had only raised to 108. I thought, okay, maybe this won't be too bad after all. But at the 30-minute mark, it had risen to 152. At the 45-minute mark, it was at 184. And at the 1 hour mark, it was still higher at 195. Wow. Now, to put this in perspective, let's compare the blood sugar rise I got from this potato with some of the blood sugar rises I experienced with more notorious blood raisers. For example, when I ate a Snickers candy bar by itself, It only raised my blood sugar to 161 at the 30-minute mark and 166 at the 1-hour mark. And when I ate 2 Hershey bars, they only raised my blood sugar to 169 at the 1-hour post-meal test. So the potato, in comparison to candy bars, at least for me, is the grand champion blood sugar raiser. And one thing we need to keep in mind is that nobody eats a meal of 1 baked potato. We eat potatoes with all kinds of other foods. So if we tack on the fast-acting carbs of the potato with carbs from a soda and a piece of French bread and maybe a dessert, all of those carbs will add up and produce an absolute blood sugar catastrophe. What the evidence suggests, and this little test certainly bore this out, is that for a diabetic to put a big old baked potato or a helping of French fries or fried potatoes or hash browns on their plates is not all that much different from putting a large piece of pie or a couple of candy bars on your plate, at least when it comes to blood sugar. Sure, the potatoes will have more nutrition, but at what price? It's just not worth it. So in conclusion, remember the big 4 starches: bread, pasta, potatoes, and rice. Avoid them, alter them, or substitute for them if possible. And if you must eat them in small portions and test your blood sugar about an hour after your meal to see how they've affected you. A salad is a wonderful substitute for potatoes. Salads have fewer carbs, and the carbs they do have are released much more slowly into your bloodstream, allowing your poor, exhausted, overworked pancreas a much more relaxed time of it. And consequently, the numbers that will show up on your blood sugar monitor will reflect that and will be much more acceptable. Don't just cut out desserts and soda and then indulge freely in the starchy foods. Take out your little hatchet and chop away most, if not all, of the big 4 starches from your diet, or make substitutions for them, and you'll be the healthier for it.